auto exposure. Hello, platform 11, it's a class 345 train. Until recently, about 2 weeks ago, you could only get the purple trains out as far as Hayes and Harlington, the class 360s. And there was one over there early on the previous service. Only they were going to Heathrow as part of TFRL every half an hour. 2 weeks ago though, they started running the class 345 purple trains to Heathrow. So I thought we'd catch one. Also, this is carriage one. The Hayes and Harlington trains have been 7 carriages long, so this is now carriage two. They've added on the additional entering carriage three. They've become 9 car trains, which is what they were always originally meant to be, but for a while they're running with 7 car formations, but now they're running them as 9 car formations. I've just entered number 4. It goes a long way down. That is going from 4 into number 5 into 6. That ran out of fingers. And this is 7, 2 more carriages. And that's 7 to 8, and this is number 9.
Next station, Heathrow, Terminal 5. See it, say it, sorted.
They said the next station was Terminal 5, but the next station is clearly going to be either Acton Mainline or Ealing Broadway. I don't think it's fast to Heathrow. That's what the express does. This is not the express. The PA just came on and said that the train destination had changed to Terminal 5, but that's what it was. I don't know what's happening. So let's wait and see where we stop first, because the screens that were now blank were saying that the next stop was Heathrow T5. Surely it's got to stop. The map even says so, and the map, I note, now includes Heathrow Terminals 2 and 3 and Heathrow Terminal 4. And that's slightly wrong, because of the current situation, nothing is stopping at Terminal 4, because the actual Heathrow terminal itself is currently closed and not open at Terminal 4. So I think these trains would have normally gone to Terminal 4, but instead they're sending them to Terminal 5. That may be what some of the confusion is about. I feel like we should be stopping at Acton Mainline, you know, and all the others. Ealing Broadway, West Ealing, we appear to be slowing. Okay, we're on the move. Two things, real quick, before the PA interrupts me. Firstly, is that you need to read the London to Reconnections article about why this is phase two of 5 phases of getting Cross Ilyes Perth up and running. They've written a brilliant article which explains everything in a lot more detail about what's been going on and why it's taken so long. Also, there's this diagram here, which is actually from a Crossrail video that's on their YouTube website, that explains about the 3 different types of signalling systems that these trains have had to contend with. And that's what's been the delay. There's been like software problems getting these class 345s to deal with the signalling out at Shenfield, which is different to the signalling system in the core section, which is different to the signalling system which runs out here, out west, beyond Hayes and Harlington, going through the tunnel that takes you down into Heathrow. Again, diagram on screen, and there's a link
between the train and the platform
below. You should go and watch that video too. TFL, these trains, there are just too many announcements. Like the audio pollution on these 345s is like you couldn't have a nap and have a snooze, because you're being plagued every 60 seconds by something. Oh, there's a brand new sign at Southall. So that over there is the bay platform at Hayes and Harlington, which up until a couple of weeks ago was as far as the class 345s are going.
This is the TFL rail service to Heathrow Terminal 5. Next station, Heathrow Terminal 23.
That is correct. So we'll come off the main line, around the curve, go down into the tunnel, and our next station will be one of the Heathrows.
Next station, Heathrow Terminal 23.
Curve. Here's the cutting. Here comes the tunnel. Okay. So that's a 9-car train in on the platform of 2 and 3. That is so long. Ahead of schedule. I'm just thinking, is this the first time I've been on a 9-car? This might be the first time I've been on a 9-car purple train. All the others have been 7.
TfL rail service to Heathrow Terminal 5.
Okay, we've left Terminal 2 and 3 station. I may be the only person on this train. I mean, it goes, the 9-car train that you can see all the way down. Oh no, there's one other person down there. I mean, it's good for social distancing. You could really distance yourself on a 9-car train. And we're approaching Terminal 5, so my first time.
Next station, Heathrow Terminal 5, where this train terminates.
To Terminal 5 on a purple train. So I've walked down to the front of this platform. Expresses come in on the other side, TfL Rail come in on this side, and we just need the glorious shot of looking all the way down the platform. I always do this thing about saying chat to staff, because staff know best. I've been chatting to a gentleman, I don't want to name him, and he's given me some awesome info. A little while ago, I tried to, and again, it's on screen now, and there's a link to my download page on my website. I tried to work out what the Class 345 Purple Train Elizabeth Line service pattern might be, and I still don't know if that's right or not, but what the gentleman here is telling me is that what's happened is that in the future, what they think is going to be the case is that there'll be 3 purple trains from Paddington going to Terminal 4, obviously none at the moment, and then 2 purple trains here to T5. In addition to that, there'll be 4 Heathrow Express trains. Also, Heathrow Express is now being operated by GWR, and GWR might actually bring in new rolling stocks instead of those right now. Instead of the Heathrow Express, there'll be the GWR trains. But that'll mean 6 trains an hour to T5, 3 trains an hour to T4, which means back up at 2-3, which they sometimes call Heathrow Central, you'll have 9 trains an hour from Paddington, which is well served. So a quick shot of it leaving, and I think we're almost done.